Hey singers, I'm Justin Stoney, the founder of New York Vocal Coaching, welcoming you to episode 12 of Voice Lessons Online, the show where passionate voice teachers from all over the world help us learn from some of the greatest singers of all time. Today we're studying a singer who's been an inspiration for over 60 years. Child prodigy, 25-time Grammy winner, R&B, funk, soul, pop pioneer, and a smile that could bring sunshine into anyone's life. Pretty much impossible not to love Stevie Wonder. Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Someone born like you would make my dreams up to the end. Ooh, every superstition. Watch her face and man. Can't wait to hear from our team of experts. First, Arbender Robinson is here to talk about Stevie's mastery of rhythm.
Hey friends, music lovers. Let me just start by saying that I truly believe that Stevie Wonder is the greatest musician of all time. There, I have said it. That is my personal opinion, and he can do no wrong in my book. Remember, episodes ago, I mentioned something. I said great artists will often encourage their audiences to sing along with them. Yeah? Stevie Wonder does the same thing. Check it out right here.
Repeat after me and say this. Ever let me know we definitely are together. Let me hear say this, say.
Now you'll be singing that melody for the rest of the day. Did you notice something else? Stevie Wonder, in my mind, normally lives in this soul or funk genre of music, but this song has a Caribbean, almost a reggae feel to it. What are ways that we can do that? As vocalists are diving into different styles and genres, we want to play around with some ideas. One, the instruments that are used in the song. Two, the sounds that we create out of our mouth. What sounds are we creating, and how does that give value to the style? And finally, how we play around with the rhythms. Is it a simple one, two, three, four, or one, and two, and three, and four, or one, two, three, four, right? There are so many different ways that we can play around with rhythms, so many different ways that styles of music play around with rhythms. Let's listen and hear numerous ways that we play around with the rhythms, the melody, and the sounds that are coming out of our mouth to really give this song the feel that it needs. Check it out.
From the park, I hear rhythms. Bob Marley and all his sons are hard.
Isn't that awesome? Now let's listen to another piece of the song where we will hear different rhythms, a few different sounds, and a slightly different melody within the same song. Check it out.
Jamming to the break of night.
master. He is a master. So in your own listening, start to see if you could recognize the way that different artists play with the rhythms and the melodies and the sounds as we navigate different styles of music. All right. Thanks so much. Bye.
Awesome, Arbender. Next, Kacey Velazquez. Tell us what you've learned from Stevie's resonance.
Hey everyone, I am so excited to talk about Stevie Wonder and what makes his voice so unique. One of the things that makes his voice so special is his bright tone. And he does this by doing many things, but primarily by raising his larynx when he sings for stylistic effect, adding a little bit of twang, and keeping his vowels nice and bright. Let's take a listen to this next clip for some modified bright vowels. So cool. We can hear vowels like E and A, nice and bright, even vowels like I. I is an awesome example because I is a diphthong, so we've got two vowel sounds in one. We've got ah and E, I. And Stevie really leans into that E part of the vowel, keeping things nice and consistent and bright. So amazing. We can hear consistency, clarity in this tone. It's nice and bright. He also, down to the consonants, is super intentional. His R consonants, for example, he barely articulates them. He comes right off the words that have R's in them. And that's because when you make an R sound, when you say it or sing them, your tongue needs to retract. And by doing that, you get a little bit of a darkness to the tone. He avoids that to keep the consistency down to the details. So if there's anything you can learn from Stevie Wonder, it's that you as the singer have all of the control. So dive into your toolbox and explore what your voice can do.
Thanks, Kacey. Next, David McCall. Talk to us.
A part of what makes Stevie Wonder such an incredible vocalist is his ability to make singing feel conversational. It's almost like he's speaking directly to you. Stevie has studied voice since the late 1960s, specifically speech-level singing. Now, to put it simply, speech-level singing is the vocal technique built upon the idea that we should keep the larynx in the same position as when we are speaking when we sing, to help eliminate any vocal strain or reaching sensations. Now, check out this performance in which Stevie gives a masterclass on how speech-level singing can make your singing feel like a conversation. Another way Stevie keeps his singing conversational is by, well, keeping it conversational. He sings smooth and connected phrases that mirror our speech patterns. And sometimes he employs a little trick we call elision. That's when you omit certain sounds and to ensure the smoothness of a phrase. For example, you'll hear Stevie, instead of singing, "You never stop your cheating ways," you'll hear, "You never stop your cheating ways." Listen for yourself.
Oh, you never stop your cheating ways with another guy. You laugh in my face. What I love must not be straight. What I love. Oh, baby, baby, baby. Yeah. I don't know why I love you. You and me.
Lastly, he communicates from the heart, which started when he was just a kid. In 1962, a 12-year-old little Stevie Wonder wowed audiences with the jazz tune Fingertips, Parts 1 and 2, which wound up being Motown Records' second number one hit and a launching pad for little Stevie Wonder. Listen to him work the crowd.
Yeah, just a little bit of soul. Yeah. Clap your hands just a little bit louder. Clap your hands just a little bit louder.
You can hear the artist in his element. I love it. There's not an insincere moment. He's communicating directly to his audience, keeping his singing conversational. So keep learning, keep it conversational, and keep singing from the heart.
Excellent points, my friend. And Kristy Bissell, what about Stevie's ability to go beyond technique?
So when we are learning how to sing, one of the first things that we learn about is breath support, right? And so when we're looking to the singers that we love and appreciate and we go to watch them and they're not doing what all of our voice teachers have told us to do, which is, you know, usually breathe low, have that breath support. So why is it that when we watch someone as amazing as Stevie Wonder's, why is he not doing that breath? Because he doesn't have to. He could certainly learn it and maybe perhaps it would help him. But I think the main thing to know is that when we're singing, there's something deeper than just vocal technique. The deeper thing is having something to say, being excited to say that. How badly do you want to share that with an audience? And that breath support that he's using is minimal. It's not super supportive. He's not an opera singer. He's just getting by with what I call survival inhales. He's just inhaling like he speaks and then he sings. So watch this clip. I think this is a great example. And this is a really old recording from Abbey Rhodes, which is really cool. Take a look.
And the song. Telling me somebody's been picking in my cherry tree. Don't wanna misjudge nobody by mistake, but I hear tell someone's been digging around in my cave.
Basically, a very even through line, his speech to his singing. And that's maybe why we love singers sometimes, is how intimate it feels. It feels like they're speaking to us. And yet it's so beautiful. It's a singing voice too. So that's something to think about. You know, if you feel like I've been working on my breath and I don't sound good, maybe go to the point of what am I trying to say? How important is it that I say it? And see if that helps. Maybe that breath support will just, you know, come along, because remember, you have to have something to say. Start there.
Thanks, Kristy, and thanks to all our experts. I'm going to share what I've learned from Stevie in a moment, but first, here are some ways to take your vocal journey to higher ground.
To get to know the Voice Lessons Online team or schedule a lesson, visit voicelessonsonline.com. To get your copy of Justin Stoney's book, Sing Like Never Before, visit singlikeneverbefore.com. If you'd like a vocal course that you can do from home, check out the Voice Lessons to the World vocal course. Our 12-part program takes you on a journey from beginner to master level vocal exercises. Find it at voicelessonstotheworld.com. If you're a voice teacher looking to master your craft, join our worldwide community at voiceteachertraining.com. Finally, if you'd like free vocal tips sent to you each day, sign up at dailyvocaltips.com.
Stevie's not only one of my favorites, he happens to be a model of excellence for vocal technique lovers like us. One thing he does better than just about anybody is nasal resonance. Now, for generations, singers were told by voice teachers to lift the soft palate, never sing into the nose. As it turns out, that was very superstitious.
Very superstitious.
But why did voice teachers used to have superstitions against nasal resonance? Well, lots of reasons, but mostly it came down to not understanding the benefits.
Adding nasal resonance has many benefits. It's an additional resonance source. It takes the pressure off the vocal folds. It neutralizes the impact of vowel and consonant changes. It makes high notes easier by assisting the cricothyroid muscle, and it keeps the voice healthy and protected. That's a lot of clout for your snout.
Stevie always has a special place in my heart for basically being all the proof we need that nasal resonance is a good idea. What's so helpful about Stevie is he's unapologetically nasal. He demonstrates that nasal resonance is not just good technique, but it sounds pretty darn sweet too. Here's a great example.
And maybe too, if you would believe, you too might be overjoyed, overloved, over me. If only I see it from above, what do they know? For in romance, to love me is a chance. Maybe with that chance you will find you two like I, overjoyed, over love, over you.
Glorious. Notice that it's not just words that have a nasal consonant like chance and find. It's words like you two like I that become you two like I.
And maybe with that chance you will find you two like I.
Hear it? And that's not over joy, over love, over you. That's over.
Like I, over joy.
So I guess we can just follow our nose. But thanks to Stevie, we can also follow our hearts, our joy, our passion, and while we're at it, why not follow our smile? After all, the privilege of learning from Stevie, well, it's a wonder. We'll see you next time for more Voice Lessons Online.